Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how to use Magic Move in Keynote. So I'm using Keynote version 6. I'm going to show you how to use Magic Move, which is a transition between two slides that animates the elements on the two slides. So the first thing I want to do is I want to populate this sample presentation with a slide that has a few images and text on it. So here I have a slide that has two images and a text box. So you can have anything. You have charts on there, anything you want, as long as you're going to have the same elements from one slide to the next. Now it doesn't have to be exactly the same elements, but only the identical elements will animate. So what we want to do here is duplicate this slide. So we have two identical slides. So I'll control click on it and duplicate. Now I've got two identical slides, and that's the best place to start. And I'm going to select the first one. Go to Animate over here and add an effect. And the effect I want to add is Magic Move. And it's going to give me a little explanation of what it is, which is what I'm going to show you. And now we have Magic Move between these two slides. So the next thing I want to do is go to the second slide and move one of these elements. So let's just, for example, move this image here. Let's move this image here. And move the text up here. Now what will happen is that the Magic Move will figure out this is the same as this, and it will animate them between slides. So let's hit play and see what happens. I'm on this first slide. I'm going to click the right arrow to go to the second slide. And you can see how those three elements moved from positions in the first slide, slide number 2, to the second slide, slide number 3, between here and here. Now this also works with things like scaling and arrangement. So for instance, let's go back to what we had before and say I want the next slide to feature this photo here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move it so that it covers the entire screen. If it wasn't already at the front, I would bring it to the front here using the Arrange panel by clicking on Front. And now I have it going from here to here. It's the same three elements. So what's going to happen with Magic Move is it will simply enlarge this one and have it cover everything. And then the cool thing is I can copy this slide right here by control clicking on it, and then I'm going to paste it afterwards. Notice how the Magic Move transition got carried over, so I want to remove that, set it to none. But I do want this one to do Magic Move. So what will happen is I have the same three elements in all three slides. I go from here to here, to here. So I basically put that one back. And let's say in this one, I want this picture to fill the space. Basically in this presentation, I could be talking about these images here. I also want this to go to the front here. There we go. So we go from this to this to this. And then let's do it again where I copy it, paste down here. I want to make sure I have my Magic Moves in the right place. So none for that, and for this one is where I want Magic Move. So now it'll go back to the original of what was there. So we go through the sequence, and I can talk about that picture, and then talk about that picture, and then it goes back to this, and then I can advance to my next slide. Now there's also another type of Magic Move. I've created a last slide here where I just changed the text. So I'm going to go in here and I'm going to add I've already added the Magic Move effect here between these two slides, and the pictures obviously don't move, but the text changes. And what it's going to do is it's going to figure out, it's going to be smart enough to figure out there's one text field on this screen and then one on this screen, and then I can do a by word or by character Magic Move. So by word, what it's going to do is pick out words that are the same between the two and create this kind of effect. There's only one word that's the same, and that's the word camera, and it works out quite nicely for this. You can see what it does there. If I did the Magic Move by character, then it moves around letters. So that was quite nice. Both of those are interesting effects that you could do with Magic Move. You also have some other options here, like for instance how quickly the transition happens, kind of whether it eases in and out or neither, and goes in at a linear speed, how long the duration is between the two slides. And what to do with completely unmatched objects. You'd probably want it to fade. So if I had an image at the beginning here and it just wasn't on any of the other slides, it would just fade out when it goes to the second slide and then not appear again. And then of course you can, for any transition, you can set it whether it happens automatically, whether the slide just advances by itself after a delay, or whether you have to do the normal advancement of slides by clicking or hitting the right arrow.